Hello everybody, and welcome to the RV Inspection and Care channel. I'm Dwayne, and today's video is part one in a three-part series about a part of RVs that every RV has, and that is the exterior surface. Now, RV walls can be made of any number of things. It could be fiberglass, aluminum, gel coat, it could be a full body paint. But the thing that all of these surfaces have in common is that they need two things. They need to be cleaned regularly and then some form of protection applied against the elements. Now in the old days, the way of cleaning RVs was essentially you take a big bucket with soapy water, you've got your mitt, you've got your brush, some kind of water source like a water hose or maybe a pressure washer, and you go around the whole RV that way. And then you have to make sure that you dry it because you've got to make sure you don't leave water spots that could damage the surface, and especially if you're going to apply now protection. So the protection usually is in the form of some kind of wax, and you either put it on by hand or by machine. And again, you go all the way around the RV again doing that. Well, I think you certainly can understand that is a tremendous amount of effort and time and work. And because of that, no doubt that's the reason why when you go down the road, I think you would agree with me that we see a lot of RVs that the exteriors really need more care. No doubt the RV owner intends to do it more often, but it's such a daunting task every time you do it that the owner probably just keeps putting it off till the next day, and then the next day never comes, and that's not good for the exterior of the RV. The other possibility is that you just pay someone to do it, but unfortunately that's expensive, and that can cause delays in the care of the exterior of the RV. The good news is that in recent decades we have had really good progress being made in the products that are used for auto and RV exterior care. And these days we have new products that are able to be applied to the surface and encapsulate the dirt when they're applied. And then with the use of high quality microfiber towels, you can then remove that dirt all without the use of water at all. Now, you need both parts of this system to make it work. You can't do just one without the other. You've got to have a very good quality product that encapsulates the dirt, and then high quality microfiber products that remove it, trap it, and remove it without scratching the surface. Now, let me show you how this really works. Now, what I have here is two high quality microfiber towels, and they're folded twice, so they've got eight sections that you can use on each towel. Then I have the product that I use to encapsulate the dirt on my RV, and I'll go into more detail about it in the part two video of this series, but right now let's see how it works. Essentially, we just prime one of the microfiber towels. Now, we don't make it sopping wet, but we do make it moist, very moist. And then we'll apply the product to the surface. We'll let it start encapsulating the dirt. We will take the microfiber towel that has the product on it. We will wipe across the surface, just like this. There was some dirt there, but it was a relatively clean coach. But now we're going to take the dry towel and just make sure that everything has been dried and clean. And that is it. These are very soft, very absorbent towels. They will not harm your RV's exterior. Now, I know that some of you watching this process that I just demonstrated, you're not going to be able to get your head around this. And I know that because I've read a lot of comments on forums around the internet about these kind of products. And some just are convinced that when you use this kind of product in this way, you're just taking the dirt on the side and just moving it around and scratching the side of your RV or auto and doing damage to it. And they just cannot get their head around that this is a new kind of product. So for those folks, I thoroughly understand where you're coming from. I'm not ridiculing you in any way. If this doesn't work for you in your world, that is just fine. And really, the old methods are great. They just take a lot of time and a lot of effort, and as a result, they often aren't done as often as they should be. But I can say that I use this system that I just demonstrated, and many other RVers do as well. The product that I used, when I provide a link for that, and it will be under the comments of this video, when you go to Amazon and look at it, you're going to see that it has thousands of reviews and still is a five-star product. I don't know many products on Amazon, period, that have thousands of reviews and they're still a five-star product. It certainly means there's something worth looking into here. So I hope what I've showed you today has been beneficial for you. Don't miss the next video in this series, because I'm going to show you how I wash and wax my nearly 40-foot diesel pusher in an hour or less using this product. So be sure you look for that video as well. Well, that's it for now. Have safe and happy travels, my friends. Until next time.